What's going on, guys? This is Trevor, and in today's video, I'm going to be teaching you how to achieve the text wiggle animation within Adobe After Effects. Before we start, I'm going to show you a quick example on how you can utilize this text animation at the start of your next edit. Check it out. So if you're looking to get the nitty-gritty for this tutorial, I will be leaving details in the description below with time codes if you would like to jump around a little bit within the video to get the exact spot where I talk about one thing. To start things off, what you're going to want to do is create a new composition within Adobe After Effects. You can do this by hitting Ctrl-N or Command-N on your keyboard for Mac. Once this window pops up, type in main comp. You can call it whatever you want, but I'm just going to type in main comp to keep things simple. Next thing what we're going to want to do is create two more compositions and label one of them displacement map and label the other one text. Once you have those two compositions created, place both of them within your main comp. You can do this by simply dragging and dropping them in, like so. Now let's hop into our displacement map composition by double-clicking it and create a new solid by hitting the keys Ctrl-Y. I'm going to call mine solid. From here, click on your new solid layer and navigate to your effect and presets panel, which should be located on your right-hand side of the screen. Type in fractal noise and drag and drop it onto your solid layer. Once you have done that, go to your effect control panel, which should be up on your left-hand side, and change your fractal type to dynamic, and then bump up your contrast to 130 and your brightness to around 10. These values are really subject to your own preference. However, I've found 130 and 10 to work great. You can always come back to these values and make adjustments to really like hone in on your own unique style for the animation. But these values have worked great for me, so I'm just going to leave them like so. And there's one last parameter we need to adjust here, which would be the random seed within the evolution options. We're going to apply an expression here by alt-clicking the stopwatch. This will make a text box open up your timeline, allowing you to type in an equation, which you're going to use the formula of time multiplied by 10, which will create the fractal noise to flicker at the rate of 10. Once you finish typing in the equation, click anywhere outside of the text box and the equation will be saved. All right, so now since that's out of the way, we can now get onto the easy part, which is creating your text within the text composition. So go into your project folder and double click the text comp. In here, you can create any text you like in any font. This animation is usually completed with a handwritten font, but I would suggest mixing it up a bit and doing something unique, like using a bolder type font like Too Faced, which is kind of like my all-time favorite right now. I usually like to align the text in the center by using the line panel and adjust the size so it fits the frame nicely. This is really just all up to your own creative judgment. Once you have decided on your text, you can switch back over to your main comp, and this is where you apply your finishing touches. First, you want to ensure that your displacement map is on top of your text and toggle off the eye, making the layer disappear, so you can create a mask that will only affect the text composition. You can do this by applying the displacement map effect onto your text layer. You do this by typing displacement map into the effect and presets panel, drag and drop that onto your text layer, go into your effect controls, and change your displacement map layer to displacement map, then switch your horizontal displacement to luminance, as well as your vertical displacement to luminance as well. Now, as you start to scrub back and forth along the timeline, you'll start to see the animation come into motion and see that famous wiggle effect. If you're working with Adobe Premiere, a quick way to transfer this text over into Adobe Premiere would be using dynamic link. You can do this by quickly saving your project and dragging and dropping your main comp into Adobe Premiere's project window. That way, any changes you make in Adobe After Effects will automatically update in Premiere Pro, which is pretty handy. Anyways, guys, thanks so much for watching this video. Make sure to hit that like button below and subscribe if you are new. If you have any questions or tutorial ideas, make sure to hit me up in the comment section below. I also link all the gear that I shoot with for my edits, as well as a link to the website that I get all my LUTs. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.